Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. So today we're going to be doing pick a card reading. So this is a message from your higher self as well as your angels, okay? So this is a collective reading. Take what resonates, leave what doesn't, don't force anything. If it's not your pile, choose another pile. So we go from there. So pile one, we have this card here. To conform is to die inside. Okay, so pile one. Then we have pile two, the lotus within you awakes. I like that card. And pile three, we have feel the power of your blood and your ancestors. Right, okay. So choose your pile and I'll see you there. So pile one, if you chose to conform is to die inside, this is your reading. So it says be brave and be yourself. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to lay down your cards first, okay? Let's lay these ones down. So you have number 18, a blessing for good work. Then you have 17, a blessing on your love. Let me do this one. Yeah, so we have caressor, which is you are at the end of a cycle in your life. Call upon your angels to comfort you and to guide you to the next step. Happiness awaits you now. And then you have birds are messengers we use to connect with you. And you're actually sneaky number one. You've got four cards here, don't tell the others. So you have communication, self-acceptance, responsibility, heal thyself, and you are good enough. Full moon in Virgo. Okay, so right, let's get started with your reading. Oh, let me get comfortable. Oh, that's a bit dodgy today. Sorry if I just knocked the camera. Right, so we'll start with this card first, okay? So with this card here, to conform is to die inside, be brave and be yourself. So with this card, what it speaks of is that, my pile ones, you are the type of people that will, I don't want to say it in a horrible way. How is there another way to say it? Basically, you guys are, that sounds so bad, I can't say sheep. You're not standing in your own power, okay? You're the type of people, you like to please people, you don't want to hurt people, you don't want to upset people. So basically, you just transform into what these people want you to be, basically, what they expect you to be. So you're not actually being true to yourself, is what this card is saying. So yes, it is like sheep. And I really don't mean that in a disrespectful way. I'm just saying what I'm hearing here. So what your higher self is actually saying here is that, and your angels, you're slowly dying inside, not literally dying, but parts of you is slowly fading away because it's like you don't know who you are anymore. It's like, who am I? I mean, this could even be in a relationship. You may be in a relationship, pile one, that your partner expects you to be a certain way, speak a certain way, act a certain way, you know, but you're not actually being true to yourself because you're like a people pleaser. So slowly, slowly, you're actually losing part of yourself. And this is what your higher self is trying to tell you and your angels. Now, with this blessed work here, blessing for good work, it could even be a work environment here. It's like, you know, you don't get any acknowledgement on the good work that you put in, which Spirit is saying here that you know, the work that you do is brilliant, basically. You know, look at the flowers in her hair. Look at the birds sitting on her head with the, I think, oh, I is that kingfisher? I think that's a kingfisher. Yeah, kingfisher. Oh, there you go. We've look at me, clever. I'm not a bird watcher, by the way. Yeah, it's got a crown on it. So yeah, you are someone that is really blessed, but it's like you don't show that side of you because you I don't know, you hide yourself away. And I like this card, pile one. So if you're not in a connection right now, okay, with this blessing in on your love, sorry, I can't even see, I really should get my eyes sorted. Anyway, so with this number 17, a blessing on your love, it speaks of somebody that you're about to meet. This is a soulmate card in this deck here, the Mystic Celtic Blessing cards. This is a soulmate. This is someone that is going to bring you out of your shell, is going to make you or show you that you don't have to conform to other people's ways. You don't have to act in a certain way to please people. Okay, so this is an energy that's coming into your life to show you a new way of life, and it's going to open your eyes to a lot of things. Right? So with these four cards here, I'm going to put this in order. Right, hang on. Okay, I'm going to put it like that. Okay, so I have a little story here. Spirit and your higher self wants you to know that you need to take responsibility for the way things have turned out for you. Okay, because, you know, you are your own person. You don't need to conform to anybody else's ways or, you know, act any other way other than the way you should be acting. You know, you should be pleasing yourself. So Spirit wants you to take responsibility for this because it's like you've allowed this to happen, pile one. You know, I don't know where the fear comes from here. Spirit wants you and your higher self wants you to accept yourself. You know, sod what everybody else thinks about you. You don't need to be... And I don't know why I'm picking up, like, you know, for some of you collective, this is for some of you, I'm just saw a handbag flash in front of my eyes, trying to explain it that way. So it's like you will buy yourself nice things. I don't know whether for some of you, you've got rich, wealthy friends and they've got the good stuff, you know, like the Gucci, the Louis Vuitton and all that crap. And you feel like you need to be accepted. So you will go and buy the same thing, not copy them, but the same, you know, name brand to be accepted. This is what I'm picking up for you, pile one. And it's like, you really shouldn't be doing this. You shouldn't be trying to please other people or impress other people. Spirit and your higher self wants you to accept yourself. You need to start communicating with the people around you. You need to start opening up here. Look, you've got two 18s here. So look at angel number 1818. I don't know what 1818 is. I know a few of them, but not 1818. Okay. So yeah. Communicate. Don't be scared to open your mouth and speak your truth. When you're not happy with something or someone's telling you what to do or how you should act, you need to communicate this to them. Spirit and your higher self want you to heal yourself. Heal this part of you. Everything else about you, pile one, is lovely, but it's just that this holds you back on being the true you. And I love this card. Absolutely love this card. I believe when robins, you know, when you see a robin, that's your passed over loved ones that are coming to offer you some kind of comfort. So that's what I feel this is. So if you've seen a robin lately, that's a spirit or your spirit guides or someone in spirit that's coming to say that they're with you and they're trying to help you. And then we have, you are good enough. This is like literally screaming, you know, your higher self is screaming at you. You are good enough. Whoever is doing this to you, pile one, don't let them do it no more, okay? So let's get some cards for you, my lovely pile ones. Let's get these ones. So Spirit, tell us more about my pile one's higher self. What is their higher self trying to tell them? Oh, bloody hell. You look at this. Wow. You have a beautiful new beginning in front of you, okay? You do have this wonderful new start ahead of you. And I feel like you are about to break free from whatever these restraints are here, from these people surrounding you. And I do feel like it's going to lead you to your soulmate here. Maybe you've already met this person and this person started to open your eyes, part one. And it's, you know, maybe pointing out to you that you, this is not acceptable. You shouldn't be accepting this. So, yeah, you've got this beautiful new start coming. But there is a little bit of a warning here. You've got this fall on the back of the deck. So the overall energy is the fall. The fall is a brand new beginning, taking that leap of faith. You know, even if it is a brand new beginning in changing yourself, the way you think, the way you act, the way you deal with people, maybe cutting people out of your life, you know, that doesn't serve you. So the Seven of Wands is spirit wants you to stand your ground. You need to protect yourself and you need to protect your brand new beginning here, okay? And the reason is you've got the devil here. You have toxic people in your life. You have people that like to control you. You have people that like to tell you what to do. The overall people, the energies around surrounding you, I mean, look how many people there is here. I mean, you could actually have five people that are doing this to you, you know, because there's five people in the card here. And you know, with this card, it's like it reminds me of these people that they're very materialistic with this card, with the devil. This is Capricorn energy here. So you know, like I said earlier about, you know, maybe you're needing to buy stuff that you can't afford or you don't actually like, just to be in with the crowd, just to, you know, please them. So yeah, this is a materialistic card as well. It's also people that are greedy, people that like to influence you, but not in a good way, in a negative way. They like to play with your mind, and this is what's happening here. They like to make you feel insecure about yourself. Yeah, and it's like this, I don't know who is doing this to you, but it's like they have this way about them that is just so convincing, you know. Tell me about the devil here. Wow. Pentacles. These are karmics you're dealing with. It's either one karmic, but I do feel like it's a group of people, and I would like to be surprised if the Three of Cups doesn't come out, because that's a friendship group. But these are karmics that you're dealing with, okay? And the Five of Pentacles. Wow. So with the devil, clarifying the devil, these are the type of people. I mean, look again, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 people here. I'm telling you, 5 is a number here. It's literally screaming 5 people. To me, anyway. So with the Five of Pentacles, with the devil, these are the type of people that they don't have your best interest at heart. They'd rather see you in poverty, you know, struggling, than actually care about, how can I explain it? So, you know, if you're buying yourself something and it's leaving you struggling for that month to make ends meet, you know, to feed yourself, they don't care. They don't care. You know, it could be that they make you feel isolated sometimes. It could be even now that they're making you, they're icing you out at the moment. Tell me more about this Five of Pentacles. Oh, freaking heck. Hang on. Tell me more about the Queen of Cups. right with me, guys. You know, even though you're in this friendship group, pile one, you've got these people around you, you feel very lonely, very isolated, you know. It's like you don't feel accepted, it's like you don't belong. Oh. King of Cups reversed, Hierophant reversed, Four of Pentacles reversed, Six of Cups reversed. Wow, don't really get reversals. So this Queen of Cups looks like she's the ringleader, okay? And that's why I needed to clarify her. But it can be a man as well, guys, because don't forget these are energies. Now this Queen of Cups, you know, she has seen someone that is very insecure. Now this is like with the Devil here, it's a jealousy card. So there could be something about you, okay? We've got Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces here. I've got Taurus energy as well, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius as well. So yeah, with the Queen of Cups, you are someone that is very genuine, you're very empathic, you know, you're an empath. So it could be that you pick up on the moods of others and the feeling, you know, what's going on around you, you know, but you're a very caring, very loving, warm, kind person, and that is the Queen of Cups. But you are dealing with somebody, is in the energy of the Queen of Cups as well, who is very insecure, very needy. They can sulk, they can be very unfriendly as well, and they can be very spiteful. Now, this would actually clarify the King of Swords as well. So, like I'm saying, you're not just dealing with one energy here. There's a group of people here. King of Swords in reverse. This is someone that can be very aggressive. So if I'm describing people that you know, they can come across as being very aggressive and very controlling, rude, a bit of a narcissist, actually big narcissist, because I see even the Devil's a narcissistic person. You know, you've got this surrounding you. These energies surrounding you are really not good for you, pile one. And the Hierophant in reverse is... these people don't have your best interests at heart. They would advise you or tell you to do something or tell you something about yourself that is actually the opposite of what's true. You know, they're not honest with you. Four of Pentacles in reverse. So, you know, this upright is usually security, you know, something long-term, something not wanting to let something go, holding on tightly. And I feel like these are people that are from your past. These could be childhood friends that you've grown up with, or you've had a long relationship with them. Now, what's happening here is I feel like you're about to let them go finally. You're seeing them for who they are. You're finally waking up, and I do believe it's this person here. Hopefully they're in your life now, or they're going to be coming into your life and showing you who these people are. Okay, so you're about to let these people go. It's like you're done with them. It doesn't matter that you had a past with these people. You literally, there is no happy memories for you. If anything, these people put you down, pile one. It was constantly being put down, told what to do, how to act. You know, you are your own... You know, you're your own star, basically. You know, this is a new beginning here. You can go on and, you know, be happy, manifest what you want, have the life that you want. You've got a new beginning here. This is hope. This is clarity on the situation as well here. So we've got Aquarius energy as well. So tell me a bit more, what's my pile one's higher self trying to tell them? What more do they need to know? A bit more about the Princess of Cups. This speaks of a new love. It can be a new love, a new job. Someone could be harboring romantic feelings of villains. So we have the Nine of Cups, Ten of Wands, Princess of Wands, Five of Wands. Yeah, no, these are the other energies here. These are the friendship group that keeps coming through here. Princess of Cups is somebody that is very immature at times, can be quite demanding, can be spiteful, can be greedy. And then you've got the Princess of Wands here. This is someone that causes a lot of arguments and a lot of conflict within the friendship group, that likes to stir up trouble and likes to have the other people five against. We've got five, five, five here again. We've got a lot of five here. This person likes to, hang on guys, I thought that went off. Likes to stir up trouble, these two. And they sit back and they let the conflict begin for you. And all these people have done to you is cause you so much conflict and burdens and stress and worry. You know, it's like you walk on eggshells around these people. Let's see what advice Spirit wants to give you. So what advice would you give my pile ones? You have a decision to make. Ace of Swords. The truth has been revealed to you, okay? Maybe you don't want to see it, but the truth is actually being revealed to you. You are seeing it, but maybe you're in a bit of denial because you've known these people for a long time, because the Six of Cups, this is you've known them for a long time. So, you know, with the Two of Swords, it's time to make a decision. It's time to balance things out now. It's time to, you know, make a decision. And with the Ace of Swords here, the truth is going to be revealed to you, you know. And what Spirit, when the Ace of Swords comes out, Spirit saying that what the Tarot reader's saying is the truth. So what... God, I don't think these people want me to talk. Oof, I've got a lot of cards here. Got Justice, Libra, Seven of Swords, Three of Wands, Magician, the Lovers. I said the Three of Cups, didn't I, guys? This is a friendship group. Wow. Okay. There is someone coming into your life. I keep being drawn to you. There is someone coming. Okay. Someone that you've not met, for some of you you've already met them. It could be early days at the moment, okay? This is the Prince of Wands, fire sign, Aries. Jesus, I forgot what the air signs are. Oh my God, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. It's been a long day. I've been up since 4 o'clock this morning. I'm freaking falling asleep. Oh God, right, wake up. So Justice, Libra energy here as well. So right, let's have a look at this. My nose keeps itching, so I think you're gonna get a surprise, guys, because when my nose itches, it's usually a surprise, and it's usually a good surprise. So maybe that's why, you know, I feel like you're gonna meet this person, or you've met them and it's early stages at the moment. Right, okay. The decision that you have to make, okay, that's you that has to make this decision. You need to make a choice here, which is the Justice card. You need to make a decision and you need to stick with it, okay? Because it's only fair. You're now starting to see, you know, and this is karma, karmic justice, basically. You're now starting to see what this friendship group has been doing to you here. Because Seven of Swords, these are people that have been sneaky, they lie, they cheat, they steal, they basically overall take the piss. Oops, I shouldn't have sworn there. They take the mick, basically. You know, and I feel like what you're going to do is you're going to actually... I feel like you're going to do it in a sneaky way. I feel like you're just going to just... I know it sounds bad saying running away, but I do feel like you are going to just leave it all behind. You know, because with the Three of Wands, it's like waiting for your ships to sail in. It's waiting for something good to happen. But I also see it as turning your back on people that don't do anything for you, don't serve you. So this is what the Three of Wands is here. You know, you are the Magician. You've got the tools to do this. You're capable of doing this. You know, you're standing in your power now. I think they're going to be quite surprised that you actually do this. You're also manifesting someone into your life here, or someone's about to come into your life with the Gemini here, with the Lovers. It also could be that you're actually choosing yourself, you know, above these people. So the Three of Cups, it speaks of a friendship group here, you know, go out celebrating, having a good time. But I'm picking up that this is this Prince of Wands that's quite passionate about you. They've got their eye on you. And this is somebody that would like to ask you out on a date. This is someone that is going to be equal give and take with both of you. You don't have to worry with this, the blessing on your love. And he's got horns as well, so that can actually be the divine masculine here, you know, soulmate. So what more does my pile ones need to know, spirit? Actually, talk about the Lovers.
I wasn't going to make this bloody long reading, but God, pile one.
Tell me about the Lovers. Two Pentacles. Tell me about the Lovers. Okay, so with the Two of Pentacles, it could be that you've got a choice to make. It could be between two people. Tell me about the Lovers here. Okay, for some of you, you could actually be in a connection right now, but you're feeling unfulfilled. This person mentally drains you. So that could be what the choice is here. The Two of Pentacles is a choice between two people. So I feel like you've got this Page of Wands coming towards you, which is your soulmate here, and you're going to have a choice that you need to make here, is what your higher self is saying. God, pile one, you are complicated. Oh my goodness, there's so much going on at the moment with the Hangman here. This is like you know, sometimes we need to make a sacrifice to get what we want, to go after what we want, to be with who we want, you see. So, you know, you're going to be doing a lot of soul searching, you know, weighing up your pros and cons here as well. And a part of you, pile one, knows that you're wasting your time on the energy that you're with. You know, if some of you are in the connection, you know you're just wasting your time. So any last words, spirit, my high ones? Any last words? Any more advice? Okay. Two of cups, soulmate, connection, nine of swords, nine of wands. Got three nines as well. Nines, 999, I think, in angel numbers is a brand new beginning. It's like you're at the end of a cycle. So maybe you want to look at that as well. So you had 1818 and 999 in here. So maybe they're the numbers that are important for you to look at. So anyway. Oh, let me get a drink, guys. Hang on. Oh, wait. Yeah, I feel like this is really going to, when it comes to this decision making here, it's really going to test your, it's really going to test you, okay? You're going to worry about it a lot. Maybe you're going to have sleepless nights about it. It also could be that you need to protect yourself from these energies here that have been your friends for so long. You need to protect yourself because they have hurt you. But you have a soulmate connection here, someone who's going to bring you balance and harmony. There's an ending and a rebirth here of a situation. You've got the Ten of Pentacles here, which is guaranteed love, marriage, generational wealth here, something that you could, you know, legacies that can be, they really do not want me to speak, Jesus. Yeah, you've got something beautiful here that's coming towards you, but it's your choice, your decision, whether you want to take that leap of faith, which was the overall energy here, brand new beginning, leaving these people behind, all the people that have taken the pee out of you, you know. I feel like you've not really got a good support system around you, pile one. I feel like you have a lot of horrible people around you. I'm sure I can't really swear on here because it would be a lot worse, but you know. So anyway, my lovely pole ones, you take care, and I hope this resonated. If it did, hit like, comment down below, and I'll see you soon. Bye. Hey, pole two, so if you chose the lotus within you awakes, you are a master in light on high. Okay, so I'm going to lay down your cards first and then I'll go from there. So you have, number 33, a blessing on boundaries. A blessing of air. Oceana, take action. You're in touch with your truth in this situation and you need to trust your gut and lovingly assert yourself. Your message from your angels is spread your wings and fly. We are proud of you. I like that card. It's like a warrior. And you have blessed sight and don't let pride get in your way. Full moon in Leo. Okay, Your pile is very special here because it's this card right here. There's something about you and this card as well and a few other cards. There's something about you, pile two. I don't know whether you're aware of it or not, but you have a gift of sight, okay? You guys are gifted in, I think, more like psychics. Maybe you hear things, maybe you see things, maybe you're just not in denial about it, okay? But this is like you've ascended to a higher level. I mean, maybe you have been working on your gifts and it's like you're there now. You've become, you know, like an ascended master, you know, like a master of your gift, basically. So I'm dealing, pole two, dealing with gifted people here. which is really nice. I'm loving it. So yeah, you have the sight, you have the gift here. And it could be, okay, with the Oceania card here from the angels, where they're saying take action, you're in touch with your truth in this situation, you need to trust your gut, yeah? So it could be that maybe people around you are not willing to accept this about you. Maybe you've hid it from people because maybe you feel like that they think that you're, you know, a bit weird or a freak. I mean, I've been called that over the years, but anyway, never mind. So yeah, maybe you've hid that part of you and now you're just like, no, I'm gonna embrace this about me. You know, this is a gift. And here as well, it's like you've asserted yourself. Look at the way she's a warrior here. It's like you're putting down boundaries with people now. You're not letting people take advantage of you. You're not letting people come between what it is that maybe you're pursuing this as a career. You know, maybe you're doing this to help people. Just bear with me a minute, guys. I just want to look at the book for that blessing of air, okay? Because these are new cards. Just bear with me. Here you go. It says, may your gift of the mind be clear and open, and may worthy ideas blossom and be expressed with ease and grace in words and actions that are in affinity with the highest of your ideals. So basically, trust yourself, trust your gift. So let's look at this. This is your higher self that's telling you you have something special here, pile two, but maybe you just closed off to it. So tell me more about this lotus within you awakes, please, spirit, for my pile twos. Yeah, look at this, guys. The Queen of Cups, psychic. You know, she's an empath, she's a psychic. You have the gift of sight, the Queen of Cups does. But what's really beautiful about the Queen of Cups, so don't forget these are energies, you can be male as well, and it's Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces here. With the Queen of Cups, she's, you know, you guys are so loving and kind. Your intuition is usually spot on. Yep. Tell me more. Oh, okay. So we have the Nine of Cups, Seven of Cups, Eight of Cups. Okay, something's going on here with you, pile two. I'm picking up very strong energy here that you have walked away from your gift. Maybe you don't want the gift. Maybe you don't like the idea of having this kind of gift. Maybe, like I said, it could be people that don't agree with it. Maybe for religious reasons for some of you here. Because with the Nine of Cups, this is... I mean, look at the way the angel with the cups above, you know. You have a gift here. And it also could be people may have taken advantage of you and your gift and, you know... I've had that over the years where people would just literally just take the mick, you know, they'd come round, do me a reading, do me this, do me that. And sometimes it would just get, you know, and never ever charged anybody in over 30 years of doing this. I've never asked for a penny. And sometimes it drains you because you feel like you're being taken advantage of. So it's like you've got greedy people for some of you, you know, some of this may resonate for you, some of you it won't. But you do have people that, my throat chakra keeps closing up, with both piles now, it's like they just want to use you for your gift. So you've literally walked away from that gift. It's like, I'm not doing it no more. I don't want it. But your higher self and your angels are saying, please do not do this, because there's something very special about you. You are special. You know, a lot of tarot readers are special and psychics and blah, but there's something about you, pile two, that is very, very special. I feel like with you guys, spirit talks through you guys, you know, your ancestors and the angels and everybody, they talk through you to help other people. You're there, you're like a light worker, or you're there to help people. And where you've walked away from this gift, it's not really helping you, and it's not really helping other people that need to be helped, you know, the people that deserve to be helped. So with the boundaries card up there, it could be that spirit is saying to you, start putting in boundaries with people, start saying no, because I'm telling you, I started saying no in the end. I actually told people I lost me tarot cards. But anyway, that's another story. I hid them. Oh my God. I hope no one's watching this that oops, I shouldn't have said that on the thingy, but never mind, it's out there now. But I used to hide them because I was so sick to death of doing tarot readings for people, you know, say they want to come for a visit, but it was all about the free readings. But anyway, so yeah, you walked away from this gift, or you're leaving it behind. It's like you don't want it. It could even be that you're leaving these people behind now. You're not allowing it. So tell me more about this Eight of Cups here. You know, you have many options here, many choices. You know, there is different ways in handling the situation. It's too many spirit. Tell me about the Eight of Cups. You know, people abuse the situation, abuse you and your gift here. So we have the Magician. See, look, you're powerful. Yeah, you do. You have a lot of people that are not very good for you with the devil here, with temptation. They take advantage of you. They take advantage of your good nature, and it could be that you draw, because you're the light. You know, you're a pure soul. You tend to attract the devil energies here. So it's like you can't seem to get away from the people that are the devil, basically. Not the devil, but you know, have that they're working, you know, they're a lower vibration to you, basically, and you tend to attract them. And it's because dark likes light, don't they? They like to feed on the light, and this is what keeps happening here. And unless you put in some kind of boundary here, it's going to keep happening for you. But you know, you have the tools to handle this with the Magician. You know, yeah, you have the tools to handle this. With the Hermit here, you need to, you know, maybe take a step back, spend some time on your own, you know, spend a bit of time on your own and think about things and maybe how to deal with it. But I don't feel like you should give up your gift if that is the case for you guys. Tell me a bit more, what's my pile two's higher self trying to tell them? Tell me about the Six of Wands. Six of Coins. Yeah, so with the Six of Wands here, it's people that they recognise who you are, they recognise the work that you do or the gift that you have here. But they take advantage of it, like I keep saying, with the ten of arrows, which is the Ten of Swords. And this is because of the people's greed, it's brought about a painful ending for you. It's like you are really hurting over having to stop using your gifts, stop doing this for other people because of the people that are in your life that take advantage of it. So there is a lot of grief here, but I feel like that's your higher self trying to tell you, please don't, do this. Don't close yourself off. You know, with these people, it was never equal give and take. It was like a lot of people that was just taking advantage of you. Tell me a bit more here, Spirit. Oh, look at that. Again, it came out. Six of Coins. People taking advantage. King of Coins. So you could have had your own business at one time. It could have been, you know, because the King of Coins, this is someone that is a business owner, does very well for themselves, is financially stable, you know, is a provider here. This can be female as well. So it could be that, you were trying to do the best for other people, but they were taking advantage of your kindness, of your wealth, you know. Oh, it's okay, you know, they're doing all right for themselves. Tell me more about this Six of Coins. We've got strength and the Three of Cups. Yes, look, Five of Coins. This is what I'm saying about the Six of Coins here. It wasn't never equal give and take here. It was people that was taking advantage of your good kind nature here, and you know, the income that you were earning here. This was a group of people here with the Three of Cups. You know, it could have even been a group of friends, okay, but it is a group of people that would take advantage of you. And with the Five of Coins, you know, it may have made you feel very like alone, stressed you out. It could have caused mental health problems, you know, like depression, because even with the Ten of Swords, that's depression as well. It could have even caused financial loss for you. But, you know, your higher self is saying, take control of the situation, take control of these people, take back your power here. So what advice would you give my pole twos, Spirit? What advice would you give my pole twos? So you're the Queen of Swords. You have the intelligence. You do have the intelligence. You do see through people's BS. You do see when people's lying to you. You know when someone's genuine and when someone's dishonest. And you have been deeply hurt by these people that have taken advantage of your gifts and your kindness here. But you are the Queen of Swords, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius here. You've got the tools as the Queen of Swords to handle this in such a an honest way here, you know. You've got, but your guard is up. You are trying to protect yourself from these people. You've had enough of it now. You know, you're very logical when it comes to any situation, really. And I feel like you're finally admitting the truth to yourselves now, pole two. So any more advice? You know, the Queen of Swords, she's a badass, basically. She can handle any situation because she's been hurt. And this is what your advice to you is, that you can handle this. Now, what more advice would you give my pal to? So I feel like you're biding your time at the moment here. Or maybe Spirit is saying the advice is bide your time, be patient. There's going to be an opportunity here to act when you need to act and take back control of the situation. Give me a bit more. Yeah, look, three of coins here, ten of things. So it could be another scenario here for you, pile two, okay? It could be that there are other people that are trying to get involved in what you do. They could be trying to take advantage of the situation, you know, trying to earn an income themselves by using you to earn that money, if you know what I mean. I'm trying to explain it properly. But what Spirit is saying here is, yeah, you are biding your time here because you know that this is not going anywhere. This is like, yes, you're trying to build something here, but you're trying to build it for yourself. You don't need outside help. You don't need outside influences coming in and butting in. This is causing a lot of stress for you here. You know, a lot of stress, a lot of burdens, a lot of worry here. It also could be another scenario for you guys. It could be that Spirit wants you to go and talk to someone that you can trust, maybe get them to help you, you know, see the bigger picture. Any more advice for my pile two? So you've got the Page of Swords. Power. The Lovers. King of Arrows, which is the King of Swords. And the Four of Coins. Okay, for some of you, this also could be you and your partner. Because the King of Swords and the Queen of Swords are not seeing eye to eye. It's usually a separation or a divorced couple here. Okay? So it could have even been that you got taken advantage of by your partner here. Yeah, I feel like for some of you guys, you know, more's coming out here. There's been a group of people here that have taken advantage of your gift, taken advantage of the money that's come in. You know, what you've earned off of this, because this is someone that is a miser here, someone that is very greedy. They're all about themselves, okay? This is someone that you were in a relationship with the Lovers. This someone does a lot of spying on you. Maybe that's why you're biding your time here, or maybe Spirit's trying to warn you that this person is keeping an eye on you, and they're checking up on to see what you're doing, what's your next move. So, yeah, there's spying going on here. It also could be delayed news here. You tell me about the Page of Arrows, Princess of Arrows. Page of Arrows. Tell me about the Princess of Arrows. Oh. Yeah, the reason why they are keeping an eye on you, they can't bear the fact that you are starting again, that you're taking a leap of faith and you're going in a new direction. You have left this King of Swords behind, okay? Because like I said, the King and Queen of Swords are not seeing eye to eye. They're either separated or divorced or going for a divorce. So yeah, the reason there's spying going on here is because they can't bear that you've moved on, that you've taken your gift with you, yourself with you, and you've moved on here. This person feels rejected by you. And also you was not satisfied in this connection, you know, you felt unfulfilled. You thought this person was your soulmate. You thought you had a Two of Cups connection with this person, but I think you had your eyes opened here that you had to make a decision and you realised that this person wasn't, you know, that person for you. And I do feel like you're still waiting for your soulmate to come along. So my pile twos, I'm going to leave it there. I hope this resonated for you. If it did, please hit like and comment down below. Love to hear from you. You take care and I'll see you soon. Bye. Hey, pile three. So if you chose, feel the power of your blood and your ancestors, you are not alone. So let's lay that there and I'll get your cards first. You have a blessing for those who are nearing their final breath. A blessing for a fresh start. Problems that have held you back are being cleared. We are monitoring it. Rosetta, you have a gift for working with young people and your divine purpose involves helping, teaching or parenting children. You have shadow treasures. And you've got two of these. Show the world the real you, full moon in Aquarius, and the end of a tough cycle approaches, full moon in Capricorn. Okay, my pile three. So if this is upsetting, please don't stay and watch, okay? I want to start with this card first. Feel the power of your ancestors. With this card, your ancestors are screaming at you at the moment. So your higher self is trying to tell you and your angels that your ancestors are really trying to get your attention at the moment. Okay. And for some unknown reason, you're not hearing them. And you come from a long line of, you know, your line, your bloodline goes way, 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 way back. Maybe you're not even aware of this. And there is one ancestor here that is trying to reach you to help you. I wish I knew what, because I've actually have a meditation that I use for ancestors. So you can get in touch with your ancestors through meditation. So that might actually help. So maybe look on YouTube to reach out to your ancestors through meditation to contact them. That might help, okay? So with this card here, it could be that you're dealing with someone that is about to pass away, someone very close to you, someone you love a lot. I'm going to clarify this. Or it could be someone has actually moved on into the next world. You know, they're an angel now. I love this card. You know, and you are going through a lot of hurt and pain at the moment. But even though you don't see it right now, and this could be why your ancestor is screaming at you, that there is this blessing for a fresh start here. You know, maybe you feel like you can't move on, you can't see the way forward in this situation. But they're saying here, your higher self is saying, and your angels here are saying that you're at the end of this tough cycle. So it could have been someone that you've been looking after for quite a while that's been sick. But there's something in the shadows here, and I feel like it's to do with the ancestors here, that there is treasures awaiting you. There's something they need to tell you. And this Rosetta here is beautiful, actually. You could work with kids already, you could work with young people, but you have a divine purpose. There's something here that your ancestor is trying to really tell you here, and I'm going to try and find out. So tell me about this ancestor here. What are they trying to tell my pile three? What is this ancestor trying to tell my pile three? Tell me what this ancestor needs to tell my pile three. Four of Wands. Tell me a bit more. too many spirits. Come on. Hang on. Let's do that again. Tell me a bit more about this. They want to flip, but they're not flipping. Okay, let's ancestor wants to sell top three spirit. Wow. Judgment. Deck. So we have the moon, the devil, and the four of swords. Go with me, guys. Tell me about the devil. More about this devil. Just bear with me, guys, okay? I need to get to the bottom of what this ancestor is trying to tell you. Ten of Cups. Three of Cups. About the devil. Tell me about the moon. Just bear with me, guys. I just want to get a clear message here. Tell me about the moon. I feel like this is really important for you guys. Tell me about the moon. What's the moon here? Ace of Pentacles. Tell me about the Queen of Cups, Chariot in reverse. No. Six of Pentacles, right, okay, I thought as much. I just needed to get a bit of clarification here on these cards before I said what I thought I was seeing. So what this ancestor is trying to tell you, okay? So some of you could be married. You could be starting a new chapter. You know, you could be going on to get married, moving in with someone, committing to someone. You know, this Four of Wands is all about commitment and happiness. You know, a wedding here. But something's being hidden from you, something you're not seeing. It's like an illusion, okay? There's something unseen here in regards to this connection here. You're dealing with someone that's in the devil energy here. Whoever this is that you're about to marry, for pile three, table resonates, okay? You're about to either get married or take the connection to a next level. You're dealing with a Page of Cups. You are the Queen of Cups, okay? You're dealing with someone that is emotionally immature, can be someone that doesn't handle things in a mature way. They're full of empty promises as well, okay? So, because if you look in this cup here, there's a fish. Now, with the Chariot in the reverse, this is failed plans. This is things not happening the way you thought they were going to happen. It's like empty promises, okay? So, this person's offering you a cup with a fish in it. you think you're getting your Ten of Cups here, which is happily ever after. Happiness, children, moving in together, getting married, starting a life together. You know, love, marriage. But you're not getting that. You're getting the Page of Wands here. And I'm sorry to say it, my pile three, but I am a very honest tarot reader. Your ancestor is telling you this is a big mistake. Okay, this is why this ancestor is very desperate to talk, you know, to communicate with you. But it's like you're not hearing. You may not even be seeing the signals, you know, or the signs. You are a Queen of Cups. You are someone that is very loving, very kind. You're warm, you're generous, okay? The Queen of Cups is an empath, a psychic. Your intuition is usually spot on. They're telling you, listen to your intuition. Something is telling you, it's actually bothering you. You are having doubts is what I'm seeing here, okay? Because the Six of Pentacles is in reverse. The Six of Pentacles upright, it speaks of equal give and take. It's sharing, it's being equal with one another, but there's no equalness here is what this ancestor is saying. Because you are a queen, you're dealing with a page. And I do feel like your intuition is telling you that this doesn't feel right. You know, the Ace of Pentacles is a brand new beginning. It's marriage, it's a new job, it's moving on, it's, you know. And I don't know why I'm picking up here that I feel like because you're going through an emotional time at the moment, or you've gone through an emotional time over losing this person, this energy here, the Page of Cups, is actually taking advantage of your emotional state. It's like you're not thinking clearly. Let me clarify this. Card here, the person who took their final breath or is about to take their final breath, please spirit. Tarot in reverse. Tell me about the tarot in reverse. In reverse. Whoever this is that's moved on into the afterlife, okay, this is someone very close to you. They're very worried about you. They're watching you as well. So not only do you have your ancestor that's trying to call out to you, you also have this person in spirit that's trying to talk to you as well, guys. With the Page of Swords, this is a spying card. This is someone that is watching you. This is someone that's keeping an eye on you. Now, with the Tower in reverse, it speaks of... I'm losing my train of thought here. Oh my God, my brain's just, you know when you go to say something and then it just goes. It's like this person in spirit is saying, you're having trouble breaking away from this energy here, this Four of Wands, this Page of Cups here. It's like you, why can you not break away? I get it. This is what this person in spirit is trying to tell you, is that if you go ahead with the marriage, this commitment, okay, you know, you're dealing with the devil here. What this person in spirit is actually telling you is that once you go into this, it's going to be very hard for you to break away from this devil energy here. I feel like this person's very abusive. Maybe you've not seen hang on, let me come back to that in a minute. Let me get this message across from this person in spirit. If you were to go in through with this marriage, you're going to find it very hard to break away from this person, from bad things that might happen, okay? You're going to find it hard to break away from this devil energy here. And I've got a funny feeling here, okay, that they're showing you this really nice side to them, but you don't realize that they've actually got a very dark side to them. And I don't want to scare anybody, but this is what your ancestors are saying, and this is what the person in spirit is saying here, okay? This is like very, I'm getting quite emotional. So I feel like the person in spirit is getting very emotional about you, pile three. Tell me about Ten of Pentacles. Tell me about the Ten of Pentacles. Ten of Wands. So we have 10, 10, 10 here, okay? Look up angel number 10, 10, 10. There's a message there from this person in spirit to you and from your angels, because this is not just from your higher self, it's from your angels as well. The Lovers, the King of Cups, this is a couple. So what this person in spirit is saying, you know, the Ten of Pentacles is guaranteed. It's for life. It's two people growing old together. And this is where I feel like once you get into this relationship with this person, once you make that commitment with this person, you are going to be stuck with this person. It could be to do with financial reasons, you know. It could be children that are involved here, but you are going to be in this for the long haul. And with this Ten of Pentacles is going to come, and the Lovers here, is going to come a lot of worry, a lot of burdens, a lot of stress. Your mental health is going to suffer. You're going to have so many responsibilities. This person's going to put so much on your shoulders that you don't deserve. It could even be that, you know, if you come from money, if this person left you a legacy here, because this is a legacy, this is going to be, this energy, this devil energy is going to end up maybe taking control of the Ten of Pentacles here that you have. This could be why they're really desperate to talk to you. Tell me about this blessing for a fresh start here, please, Spirit. Tell me about the blessing for a fresh start from the pile three. You have the Empress, the Page of Pentacles, and the Four of Pentacles. A lot of pentacles and the Ten of Swords. So we have all four tens here. So even look at that angel number as well. And we are looking at the blessing for a fresh start. And I do believe all the tens means an ending of something. And it's now time to start again. So you are the divine feminine, okay? You've been through a lot in your life. But you are still very caring, you're still very loving. what I'm hearing here, guys, is what spirit is saying here is hold on to what is yours, hold on to your money, your wealth here, hold on to everything that is yours, you know, because it is yours. Don't let it go, don't let someone take advantage of you, because you've got the ultimate betrayal here. This is somebody that is going to betray you or will betray you. And then you have the Ace of Swords. The Ace of Swords is the truth is being revealed to you, you know, truth and clarity. What the tarot reader is saying is the truth. And it could be this reading may be speaking the truth. Because if you are having doubts and you are having a few worries, you know, second thoughts on this connection, you know. So what advice would you give my pile of threes? What would you advise them? The world on its side. So, you know, the world is completing of a cycle. It's closing one chapter and starting again, okay? But you're not there yet. You're not there. You're undecided of what to do. You are thinking very long and hard about this situation here with the Hermit. What more would you what would you advise my pile three? Four of Cups is feeling rejected, or it could be the advice to you is to reject this connection here. It's not going to bring you any satisfaction. Let's get some more advice for you guys. Two of Cups. Two of Cups. Seven of Cups. And the eight. Is it eight? No, nine. Yeah, look here. Death. So this blessing new start for you, and the advice from spirit here is saying that there is a connection for you, that two people that are going to be in love, you know, and it's a mutual love here, soulmate, if you believe in soulmates. This is someone that's going to treat you really good. You have a choice here to make. You know, the choice is yours at the end of the day. You have to make a decision that's right for you. But you have another option that's available to you. When, you know, if you decide to take the road of not going through with this devil energy here, you will be single. You will be doing financially really well for yourself. You know, you are missing your 10th pentacle here, which is love. You know, this is luxury. This is living your best life here. And then you have death on the back of the deck. Death speaks of, you know, it could be an ending of a connection, an ending of a job. It's just, you know, it can be a transformation in yourself. You've got Seven of Swords here. That's a sneaky energy here. Someone that's not to be trusted. Someone that's trying to lie, get away with something. Tell me about Seven of Swords. We have the Eight of Swords and the Two of Pentacles. So with the Two of Pentacles, you are weighing up your options here. Whether, you know, you are deciding whether you want to end it or whether you want to go through with this, okay? But the problem is you're all inside your head here, pile three. You're very worried about your future, how, you know, the outcome's going to be, if you're going to be okay. But sometimes the Eight of Swords is unfounded worries, you know. Sometimes you're worrying over something that's not there. And I don't feel like it's worry about your future. I feel like it's a worry about whether you're making the right choice here, even though you know this person is a sneaky energy here. Tell me more about the Seven of Swords. Walking away, leaving it behind, starting a new beginning here, passionate new beginning here. You have the Seven of Pentacles. Even though it may be hard to leave this person behind, very difficult for you to leave this person behind, you know, there is a passionate new start for you out there. You know, it's a new, it could be a new romance, it could be a new job, it could be just new, you know, a new home. It's just moving forward and feeling very passionate. And I feel like when, you know, if you do decide to leave this person with the Seven of Swords as well, I feel like you're going to do it in a bit of a sneaky way. You know, I don't feel like you want to hurt this person. I don't feel like you want any backlash from them. So you may do it in a sneaky way, you know, because sometimes we've got to do it in a sneaky way, haven't we? But you have invested a long time into this, and you hopefully, you know, if you decide to do that, you will be walking away from this person. Is there anything that my palfreys need to be warned about, Spirit? Is there any warning that you want to give my palfrey? You're dealing with a karmic here. Tell me about this Five of Pentacles. Seven again. Wheel of Fortune again. You're dealing with a karmic. It's just going to bring you nothing but hard work. Nothing but, you know, with the Seven of Pentacles, I see it as sometimes as being a failure, you know, putting in a lot of hard work and not seeing anything come of it. Because if you look at the tree here, there's no leaves on the tree, there's nothing blossoming here. It's like a dead end, basically. Okay, where's that card gone? Oh, there it is. It's like flipped over there. You know, this person could end up putting you in poverty here, that you're going to end up losing your generational wealth here. Like I said, there could be something to do with them taking control of the finances here, or controlling the finances here because they're greedy. We've had that. So with the Five of Pentacles here, it could be that you'll end up in poverty, or this person's just going to end up making you feel ill at times, you know, like, you know, mentally ill, because we've got the Eight of Swords as well. They're going to cause you a lot of grief as well with the Five of Pentacles. You know, I feel like this person will isolate you from people that love you and care about you as well, because this is an isolation card as well. You know, and you are in control of your own destiny with the Wheel of Fortune. And I do feel like you're dealing with a karmic here. So this is the warning that Spirit's giving you here. If you were to go ahead with this, but everybody has free will, okay, palfrey, you do what you need to do for yourselves. But what Spirit's saying, the warning here is that, you know, your fortune could change for the worse. There's nothing good that's going to come of this, nothing that's going to grow. You're going to end up in, you know, you can end up in poverty, you can end up with mental health problems, you can end up ill with this, you know, a lot of worry, a lot of grief. Any more, Spirit? Okay, then. Oh, look at this. Oh, I'm going to leave it right here, guys, for you guys. You know, with the Three of Pentacles, with the Three of Wands, it's waiting for your ships to sail in. It's waiting for something to happen, you know. Being hopeful for something to happen. And Spirit is saying that have that hope. because what's on its way to you is the Ace of Cups, which is the second chance at love. It's them giving you a second chance at a genuine love here, someone that's going to care and love you and respect you. So, you know, this is a new relationship that's on its way to you. And this is the page, this is the Knight of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces here. Virgo, Capricorn, Taurus we've got as well. But with the Knight of Cups, this is someone that is very romantic, has romantic feelings for you. So the person you will eventually meet is someone that's going to be very passionate about you. Okay, they're going to pursue you here. This is someone that is like a Prince Charming. I think it's going to be total opposite of what you're used to. And this person is a Queen of Pentacles. And as I said, these are energies. This is someone that is financially stable, very humble, very caring, very giving. They like to, look after the people that they love, you know. And I see these, the Pentacles, the King and the Queen, as marriage material as well. And plus, they're going to see that your self-worth. They're going to see you for you, you know, who you are as well. I feel like you're going to have a lot in common, you two. There's going to be mutual respect here, mutual love here. So I'm going to leave it there, my pile three. I hope this resonated for you. You take care and you have a blessed day. Bye.